Hi, this is Merrill Jinks with the Big Helper Real Estate Group. Today I'm going to be talking about how much should your interest rate be? There are a lot of factors that can make your interest rate go up or down. Obviously, if you have fantastic credit and you're putting a really large down payment, you're probably going to get a lower interest rate. Also, if you're using VA financing or FHA financing or conventional financing, all different loan types have different rates for them. And then within those loan types, are you doing a 30-year fixed rate mortgage, or are you doing an adjustable rate mortgage, or are you doing a 15-year mortgage? All of those factors can also have an impact in adjusting your interest rate up or down. The vast majority of people are using conventional financing and they're doing a 30-year fixed rate mortgage. So I'm going to focus my attention on those people today. Freddie Mac has a really incredible website. We're going to post the link here in the video where you can go to find out what average interest rates are right now. As of the time that we're shooting this video, average interest rates today are 3.28%, according to this Freddie Mac website that we're going to post in the video. That rate, however, has 0.7 points. So, and this is sometimes confusing for people, but your points are how much are you paying in fees in order to get that average rate. And so on average rates are 3.28%, and people are paying an average of 0.7 points, which is 0.7% of the loan amount. So if you were getting a $100,000 loan, you'd be paying $700 in fees in order to get that rate. Now, rates are not, you need to work with your lender because the rates can go up or down. First of all, rates fluctuate every single day, so it's never set at, okay, that's my rate, so that's what I should get. They go up a little tiny bit every single day, up or down. And then also another big factor is how much do you want to pay in closing costs? So you might say, you know, I really don't want to pay a lot in closing costs. So the lender can say, well, let's increase your rate so that instead of paying points, you'll get a points credit. You'll basically get a rebate to cover the closing costs for the loan. And then other times you might say, no, I don't care. I'll pay high closing costs. I want the lowest possible rate and the lowest possible payment. You can sometimes pay more points to get that interest rate even lower. So rates is a fluid thing, and you need to have a conversation with what your goals are with your loan officer, and they can tell you what kind of rate you would be looking at depending on your credit score, depending on your down payment, depending on your loan type, and depending on your tolerance for closing costs. That's going to be where you determine. But again, right now, check this Freddie Mac website out. That'll give you a really good idea of what average rates are, and it doesn't just let you see today. It lets you see a graph of historically where rates have been. So you not only are you going to get a feel for whether you're getting a good pricing based on, you know, what average people are getting right now, but you're also going to get a good feel for you know, whether or not historically speaking, is your rate good? Obviously 3.28% is smoking good historically.